Sequencer firmware version 1.2 brings some new features. Swing, FLAM, also called Ratchet, and an analog clock divider. In this video I will show the new features and explain how they work. Swing. Sequencer now includes a swing clock generator that works with all kinds of clock sources. When activated, every second step is delayed by an adjustable factor proportional to the step length. To activate Swing, just go into the config menu by pressing func and long press conf. Then select the swing parameter by pressing func and forward. Currently there's no swing, and by pressing the buttons we can adjust the swing amount. The maximum swing amount will result in a 3-to-1 rhythm. The swing clock generator works with all play directions. If you, for example, select random as play direction, you still get the same swing feel. FLAM. Sequencer includes a FLAM or ratchet effect that can be used to create subdivisions of steps, as well as various kinds of tuplets, e.g. triplets or quintuplets. There's always one instrument that triggers the FLAM effect, and multiple instruments can be set to react to this trigger. To enter the FLAM configuration menu, press func and long press last step. We can see the trigger instrument in blue, currently the symbol. We can see the FLAM target instrument in red, here the hi-hats, but we can also select more targets. And finally, the 8 non-instrument buttons show the FLAM type. If I now activate FLAM by selecting the first type, you can hear that the effect is triggered every time a simple step is set. We can select other target instruments as well, and now you can hear the effect triggering the toms as well. Let's have a look at the FLAM types. There are three types that create subdivisions of a single step. 2 beats per step, 3 beats per step, and 4 beats per step. If we select the hi-hat as the triggering instrument, we can get continuous 30 seconds or 30 second triplets. The other four types create subdivisions of multiple steps. 16th triplets, 3 beats for each 2 steps. Dotted 16th, 2 beats for each 3 steps. 8th triplets, 3 beats for each 4 steps. And 8th quintuplets, 5 beats for each 4 steps. If I select the 16th triplet now, we get a nice shuffle rhythm. But in order to hear these settings properly, we need to delete some hi-hat steps. I remove every second hi-hat step and activate 16th triplets. I can also program quarter note hi-hats, maybe 16th for the last bar, and try some other settings. Here are the 8th triplets with 16th for the last bar, and here are the 8th quintuplets. I think I will just play with this for a little while and show you what's possible. The FLAM trigger instrument is also affected by the settings in probability, by the way. This allows sequences with FLAMs or triplets inserted randomly. Analog clock divider. Beside the existing clock divider for the MIDI clock, Sequencer now also includes an analog clock divider. It can be used to convert a faster incoming clock to half tempo, for example. It can also be used to sync Sequencer to a DynSync clock directly. I connected my TR-606 DynSync output to the clock and run stop inputs of Sequencer. In the config menu, I select Run Stop as clock mode. If I press Start now, Sequencer will start in sync, but it's way too fast. This is because DynSync sends 24 or 48 clocks per quarter note. We can divide this clock in the clock divider menu page. We are already in the config menu, so we just press Funk and Back and can now see the divider settings. Right now the divider is 1, but if we want 16th notes, we just select a divider of 6 by pressing Song. As you can hear, Sequencer is now in sync with the 606. Other clock dividers are available. You can select 8th notes, quarter triplets, and many more. This concludes the video about the new firmware update. It can be updated via MIDI using our updater tool. That's it. Have fun!